Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Siyadeta Gadara Siva Sadi Gobhakta Vrinda.
Did anyone see on the Arabian Sea a tree trunk adrift washing ashore? As another such tree once did on the Indian coast of Puri thousands of years ago. This driftwood of ancient India was carved into the first deity of Jagannath, the Lord of the Universe. At the turn of the 21st century, somewhere in the Persian Gulf region, another carved Jagannath appeared in a coastal town, this time surrounded by deserts. After carrying the Lord onto a chariot, a group of Indian expatriates are pulling the chariot by hand in the same ancient procession as in the Lord's home across the ocean. My name is Vasudeva Das from France. I came to the Middle East to understand exactly what has brought Lord Jagannath and his devotees to these remote shores.
Thank you very much.
My name is Vijay Venugopal Das, and my wife and I were one of the first few to start implementing the Bhakti Vriksha system. We came to this place in 1988 basically to earn money and get back and live a comfortable life in India. But to our surprise, we got something entirely different and the whole direction of our life changed. Initially, we started having small programs in our house. So we used to read Bhagavad Gita verse and purports, and a few people somehow came. At that time, we had maybe about 100 devotees, out of whom about 10 or 15 were very serious. His Holiness Jayapataka Swami once said that there is another way of preaching. And maybe we could do this in ISKCON also. Having programs in small groups in a friendly atmosphere with a specific structure, we had to evolve that structure. But the point of these groups was that people were coming on the basis of friendship. And then through this friendship, they would start slowly discovering Krishna consciousness. We took the first group of committed devotees and we said, okay, each of you now start a group. And now these were devotees who had only been used to attending classes. They knew nothing else. But when we discussed how this could be done, they took to it enthusiastically.
We didn't have any structured knowledge about the philosophy, about the scriptures. We were not initiated, but we were asked to preach. We were the first members of Bhakti Vriksha program. We started in a small way in our house. And Premanandini used to do the prasadam. She gave a lot of inputs to this yatra. And she will single-handedly cook all the prasadam.
And then every few months, our spiritual master used to come over here. And then he used to discuss with us what's going on, how to correct things. And in this way, it evolved. And then there was a massive expansion after that. And very rapidly, within another 5 years, from 100, we got to about 2,000 devotees.
So in the city area, the preaching mode is Bhakti Vriksha program, where the members are literate, they can read, write and participate. That is how a Bhakti Vriksha program can be more successful. But in the interior, most of the devotees are laborers in the labor camp, and there are also grihasthas who are tailors, who are barbers, and they are very enthusiastic in preaching.
Before coming to this Bhakti Vriksha class, I worry for each and everything. So after I started reading this Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavadam, I understood that nothing is in our hand. And simply we are acting as per his guidance. That's what I have understood. Now I am not worrying for anything.
I was far away from this spiritual knowledge. After coming here, I realized who am I. what is my main purpose in my life. Unfortunately, my parents, my family also, they were not aware of, like, our education is only for the material benefit. And I'm very happy that now I'm into the streamline.
Krishna consciousness means not just aware of Krishna in the temple. We want to satisfy Krishna through our dealings with everyone. Because if we forget him, then we'll try to put our best behavior only when people are watching. But Krishna knows everything. So if you are aware of him, you cannot do any wrong.
Everyone is considered as part of the family. They are helped in all aspects of their lives. That if they face any problems in their physical health, if they face any problems in their economic situation, if they face any problems in their spiritual life, there is always someone to help them. So much so that even when it came for birth, babies have been born over here because they had a whole support system of devotees looking after them. Families developed, and then the second generation has now grown up and they've also got married, and there's a third generation also of youngsters who are now attending our Bhakti Vriksha programs. And this loving relationship carries on for the entire lifetime. Can you imagine that there was this young girl who was in the 9th or 10th standard, maybe she was 13 or 14, and Bhakti Vriksha started over here. About 20 years later, she is in America with her husband, and there they are doing Bhakti Vriksha.
My husband and myself, we conduct Bhakti Vriksha program in our house.
They are helping the temple to flourish. And their connection with us stays on. Even though they are far away in America, we talk and we find and we meet and so on. And it is not something which is isolated, that I come for a Krishna conscious program, I change my dress, there I'm a devotee, and then I take off my dress and I go home, and then I'm another person, I have another life. Instead, Bhakti Vriksha creates an integrated life where you are the same person, whether you're at home or whether you're here in the programs, whether you go to the office, everything, your whole life is tuned to be part of this community. You don't have a separate life apart from this. And when children grow up in this, as we've had a generation growing up in this, it becomes most natural for them. They have had very good experiences as devotees. All the devotees whom they knew from the time they were small, they still know them. And we find husbands for them, we find wives for them. And so they feel very much part of this community. Now, one may think that, okay, maybe this happens to Indians. This is natural to Indians. One thing is, it is actually not natural to Indians nowadays, because Indians now embrace the Western culture with much greater fervor than the Westerners themselves, perhaps. So for them to actually take to this path itself is actually quite difficult. That is one. But apart from that, it is now spread to all parts of the world. So we, especially after 2006, when I retired early from my job, so we've been traveling all over the world, wherever we've been invited. If you go to Russia, you'll be amazed to see how Krishna consciousness has taken place over there. There are no Indians in these groups. When they started taking to Bhakti Vriksha, a completely new generation has now come up in Krishna consciousness in Russia. They practice in their own Russian way. It is all integrated as part of their culture. It is completely native. They have to do everything in their own language, which is why you will find that in most part of the world, they don't have a clue much about what is going on in Russia, because Russians do everything in Russian. And there, in probably 4 or 5 years, there are more than 500 Bhakti Vriksha groups from as remote a place as the easternmost part of Russia to the other places where there are Russian speaking, including the USA, Germany, UK, Israel, wherever they are. Just like Indians are spread all over the world, nowadays Russians are spread all over the world, and wherever they are going, Bhakti Vriksha is going. That has gone to China. And Bhakti Vriksha you'll find also in South America, in Argentina. And this is an ongoing story. And why is it that Bhakti Vriksha is not just a story of Indians? This is because Bhakti Vriksha goes through friendship. So the local people, in their own way, they make friends. They know how to make friends among their own countrymen. They know what their countrymen like. They know their countrymen's culture. Into this friendship, they add the spiritual, universal spiritual element of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the one of universal love. Because the friendship which you may have among two people without Krishna in the center is one of common habits, common culture, and so on. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes into this picture, then the whole thing becomes universal, it becomes spiritual, and it becomes deep and unselfish. So Bhakti Vriksha very easily passes on this love of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to the others, because it is so natural. And when the Bhakti Riksha leader, the servant leader, when he has that love, and through his friendship he calls, through his loving friendship, he or she, they call their friends together, then it is very easy for them to transform this cultural friendship into one of spiritual friendship. And that is a secret. Once that is there, then Krishna consciousness is not alien. They don't even feel it is something foreign. They feel it is something of their own, because it is coming from the universal paradigm of love.
Children programs consist of first icebreaker. We will ask children, what do you know about Krishna? Would you like to be a vegetarian? What is the reason between vegetarian? Children will give very nice answers. Then we will chant one round mala. If children are very small, like 4 to 6 years group, then we will try to them to chant first 11 times, then 21 times, like that we increase. Because small children, beginning they can't chant 108 names. Big children, they will chant full the round. Then sloka. One sloka from the Bhagavad Gita, its explanation, then one story.
After many, many years of living as trees, they would see Krishna face to face and be good devotees of Lord Krishna again.
In between story, we ask some questions. Sometimes big children, same story they will present in drama also.
All over the world.
Coloring or making craft items.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
I understand you're a mother of a baby, but at the same time, you and your husband have just started a cell group. How are you able to do both?
Yeah, on Friday afternoon, like, I'll adjust my time in such a way that I'll put my baby to sleep. I'll give her lunch, I'll put her to sleep nicely so that she'll have some 3 hours of sleep. So in that time, I'll finish my cooking, cleaning up, doing aarti, offering to the Lord. Then my Prabhu will be calling the members. And on the Friday evening, when we have the Bhakti Vriksha, I'll take care of their kids so that the parents will concentrate on the program without any disturbance. Mm. So I'll take their kids into the room and I'll engage them. I mean, I'll make sure that they're happy, like they won't ask for their mothers.
Mm.
Perhaps the most important thing in the Bhakti Vriksha program is to maintain a good relationship with the people. They are like your a family, they are like your children. When we call them, we don't call them like formally. It's not like some push or force from our side.
Do you see each other during the week sometimes? Go shopping or invite into your house? Does it happen?
Normally, once in a week like that, we'll make some prasad and we'll go to their house. We'll just have a normal conversation.
As friends?
Yeah, best friends, like that. And in the weekdays, normally, I'll call up the people. We have children of same age.
Small talk.
It's a casual talk.
And what is your husband doing then?
Yeah, my husband, he'll also make calls to the Prabhus and all. And on the same day also, he'll make sure that whether they are coming, if they need any help, and he'll arrange the house. Mm-hmm. He'll lead the kirtan.
And the kirtan, the babies come in?
Yeah, normally babies enjoy the kirtan because the mridanga and kartal all sound. So I'll let them into the hall so that they'll enjoy, they also dance. So after that, we'll give prasadam.
So are you telling me that really there is no conflict in having a baby and running a Bhakti Vriksha group?
It's really a challenging task in the beginning, but now it's really working out, Prabhu. It's going smoothly.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda.
The Bhakti Vriksha session starts with an icebreaker. Icebreaker is an integral part of the Bhakti Vriksha program because generally people would have come back from their offices, from schools, etc. So it gives them an opportunity to freshen up, to leave their minds and to get involved in the discussions that happen in this Bhakti Vriksha program.
Suppose, Prabhu, if you get 1 million, how will you spend it?
I have some responsibilities that my family is dependent on me, so I have to think about them.
Has to be invested for the God and for the education and for the family future security.
Okay.
So before we move on to the Japa session, we read a passage from Namamrita, the Nectar of the Holy Name, in order to make the members realize how powerful it is to chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
Anyone can sit down on the road or beneath a tree and chant Hare Krishna Mantra and worship God. Therefore, it's a great opportunity, the science of self-realization. So, now we chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
These discussion passages included in the module are taken from Srila Prabhupada's books. And the members have to read the passage and they will answer the discovery, understanding and application questions. Towards the end, the Bhakti Vriksha leader summarizes the main theme of the discussion session.
To deliver the pious and to annihilate the miscreants, as well as to re-establish the principles of religion, I myself appear millennium after millennium. Why does Lord Krishna appear in his different avatars or incarnations in this material world?
Save the devotees and to punish the miscreants who are troubling the devotees.
Always make them feel secured in all the ways of life.
To re-establish the principles of religion, it says, I myself appear millennium after millennium. That's what.
Why is it said that the Lord appears basically to protect his devotees?
Because devotees are totally dependent on Lord. They are trying to surrender to Lord.
Now we will move to application question. And each one of you has to answer that question. Simple question. Do you accept Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as the Supreme Lord? Discuss your feelings towards him.
So now we come to the last part of the Bhakti Vriksha discussion sessions before we honor the prasadam. So this session is about preaching is the essence. So from this session we can understand why it is important for every member of Bhakti Vriksha to preach.
Krishna empowers the preacher. The Krishna consciousness movement spreads by the mercy of Lord Krishna and Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya's mission is to deliver the fallen souls of this age. Practically 7% of the population is fallen.
What is special about the Bhakti Vriksha program? It is based entirely in the mood of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, he says that I am the Bhakti Vriksha, I am the tree of devotion, and I am also the gardener of this tree of devotion. The fruit of this tree is Krishna Prema. My mission is to distribute these fruits of love to everybody in this world. But how many fruits can I distribute just by myself? So I want all of you to eat the fruit, relish it, and also help in distributing it to others.
My name is Chinmaya Chaitanya Das. I am Mahachakra servant of this part of the world where we have Bhakti Visha group consisting of three chakras, and each chakra having a minimum of three sectors and each sector having minimum of three cells. We have at present 36 cells and 10 sectors and three chakras. We started this from 1999 with a couple of devotees and have grown up to now 400 to 500 devotees who are always engaged in the Krishna consciousness and propagating. We meet regularly to make a strategic plan as to how to improve the preaching. The cell servants meet with the sector servant once in 2 weeks, and the sector servants meet with the chakra servant in once in 2 weeks to improve the number of cells, because a cell means it has to divide after some time into multiple cells. We can see in the from the group there may be potential servants who can be acting as a cell servant or sector servant, and they can be given a new area of responsibility and start new cells.
I'm a Girirani Radha Devi Dasi. I'm a sector servant. Sector in the sense it consists of a cluster of 3 to 4 cell groups. Each cell has 10 to 15 members and they meet in their own languages. It's like our own Indian languages, Malayalam, Hindi, Tamil and Kannada. So this group is a Tamil group, Tamil Bhakti Visha group. We are meeting here. Now they are doing chanting. After Namavarta, they started chanting.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
Chant holy name on beads since morning till evening in a group of 25 to 30 people.
Let's suppose someone is tired or hungry, what do they do?
They can break the group and go out for eat and come back. We are not forcing anybody to sit continuously, but as a group, marathon will be continued.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
इनको दीक्षा देना चाहिए कि नहीं देना चाहिए? अपना पूरा जीवन भगवान को समर्पित कर दिया था और इसके बाद भी.
माय नेम इज पुरुषोत्तम चैतन्य दास एंड आई एम प्रीचिंग टू द कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्कर इन द कैंप्स. दिस कैंप्स पीपल बेसिकली केम फ्रॉम पुअर फैमिलीज. दे आर हियर लाइक फोर्स बैचलर लिविंग फैमिली इन इंडिया एंड कम हियर टू वर्क. देयर वर्क प्लेस इज ऑल्सो very hard, 10 hours, 12 hours, but still there is no family association. So they are depressed, they habituated to alcoholic, playing cards, smoking. Bhakti Vriksha give them a family attention. They are not feeling further lonely. These workers are very, very humble and they have a service mood. As soon as we give some service to them, happily they are ready to do it. I am a logistic executive. I don't have to go to the labor camp, but when they get the happiness from Bhakti Vriksha, then I feel to go and preach them.
They cannot read a single word, and after 6 months, 7 months, you find that they can read Bhagavad Gita sloka fluently. So a study class now, Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita. Now we have started Bhakti Rasamrita Sindham. And in place of Gita, we are doing Canto 2, Bhagavatam Canto 2. Labor camps are really benefiting because they don't have too much logical questions. They simply believe and they do japa. I have seen the people changing like anything, free of tension, who are coming, lot of questions. My wife is sick, my son is not good, I don't have much money. I have no answer, only answer that you do japa. And this is the only cure for all the problems. But after 6 months, 9 months, you can see that their face glowing, no? And they are doing 16 rounds, 12 rounds, and no tension, no problem. If you ask them, you have any problem? No, no problem. All problems are resolved.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
The Bengalis are spread around the country, many of them on working visas as laborers, carpenters, barbers. Here is a Bengali community in Simantadweep. They meet every day in their neighborhood's Bhakti Vriksha community hall. This Bengali gentleman tells me what happened to him after he suffered a heart attack.
Apnar naam ki?
Amar naam hocche Madhav Krishna Das.
Ki holo?
Amar 2 bochhor age amar brain stroke hoyechilo ebong heart stroke hoyechilo. To ami hospital e chilam, doctor ra boleche amar bachar kono upay nai, kintu bhoktora shobai prarthona koreche sob jaygay ebong bhakti bikshesh somosto bhoktora amake খুব সহায়তা করেছে, তারা অর্থ দিয়ে সব কিছু দিয়ে, তারা শ্রম দিয়ে আমাকে সবাই ভক্তরা গিয়ে প্রার্থনা করাতে আমার এখন ভক্তিবৃক্ষ হরিনাম চান্টিংয়ের মাধ্যমে আমার শরীর সুস্থ হয়ে গেছে, এখন ঠিক পূর্বের মতোই আছি। আমার এক সাইড ধরে গেছিলো, আমার সাউন্ড বদ্ধ হয়ে গেছিলো, আমি হাঁটতে পারতাম না, কিন্তু এখন নর্মাল একবারে সুন্দর সুস্থ মানুষের মতো আমি এখন চলাফেরা করতে পারছি।
As a visitor, although you may have enough to treat yourself to a haircut, the local Bengali hairdresser may refuse your money. It's all a part of Bhakti Vriksha hospitality. And when you're treated to lunch in someone's home, make sure you're on an empty stomach, so you need not turn down second and third helpings.
Siksha program encourages people, giving them recognition for whatever progress they make. Otherwise, until they reach the level of 16 rounds, they are not considered as even devotees.
But when one makes one commitment in front of all the Vaishnavas and to Srila Prabhupada, it gives people the strength to follow these commitments. So we find a kind of a uniform progress in the devotees' lives.
Before I ever never sit to pray, I was thinking, why I have to pray? What the reason? Sometimes my wife force me, so why you are not praying? I say, okay, I will pray, but not with the feelings. So that now after this discussions, I feel the right time I have to start this prayer, and I have to feel, I am feeling better and better.
The Siksha program is a very essential aspect of Bhakti Vriksha program, because we have clear targets and goals to achieve in a particular time frame. Every 2 months they renew their commitments in Krishna consciousness. For example, the first 2 months we take them up to the level of Shraddhavan, which is that they commit themselves to chanting one round and attending all programs regularly. Then in the next 2 months they go up to the level of Krishna Seva, which is chanting 4 rounds and being a vegetarian. And the next 2 months takes them to the level of chanting 8 rounds, Krishna Sadak, and also following 3 regulative principles and following Ekadashi. The next 3 months takes them to Prabhupada Ashraya level, where they commit to 16 rounds of chanting, following 4 regulative principles, starting to read Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. And of course, the next 6 months would take them up to the level of Guru Ashraya.
Hare Krishna, my name is Uttama Gopikan Das. I am looking after this group of 20 devotees. One of the aspect like Vyuha, occasionally we are doing this kind of things. Every 10th week we join other cell groups. They can see our seniors and they can meet other devotees on what they learned so far. They will come out from regular routine and they will feel more happy.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
My name is Kalachakra Krishna Das, and I am one of the coordinators for the youth forum here in Madhya Pradesh.
My name is Gayatri, and I first joined Bhakti Vriksha around 10 years ago. I was just 5 years old, so I mean, the main part of the Bhakti Riksha that I liked was the Kirtan because I did not understand the philosophy.
Our focus is on conducting programs for teenagers, people aged 12, 13 and above.
And later as I grew, I started joining the youth classes. We were asked to start writing for the youth magazine.
It's that impressionable age when one gets out of the parents' ambit and comes under influence of one's friends and society. At this critical juncture, we try to give them a platform to showcase their skills, their talents, and to engage them in Krishna consciousness.
The service I was given was to write about our trip to Mayapur and Vrindavan, the holy dams.
Typically, that's the time when the youth come up with questions, come up with challenges, and we need to answer them in a very rational way, in which they don't feel that what they are doing is something weird.
And we used to also have the winter camps for 4 days. We used to do the aarti and the cooking service, the cleaning service, taking care of the deities, and we used to also go for outings together.
We find that after these programs, the youth, they come forward on their own to carry out some services at the temple.
On the last day of the youth camp, we used to perform a dance drama or enacting the pastime of the Lord. And I'm still looking forward to the next youth camp.
We all meet once a month where the different cells across the city, they combine together in a vyuha. And when we have programs like Ratri Yatra and the like, they are very eager to come and participate in the Kirtan Melas and the skits and the dramas. It's really encouraging.
My name is Srinivas. And basically, we came into this Bhakti Riksha program to one of my father's colleague.
My name is Priyanka. And my family got involved in Bhakti Riksha around 8 or 9 years ago.
My name is Resham, about 7 years ago.
My name is Amulya. I was 4.
Actually, my father wanted me to learn the shlokas as it is a part of the tradition.
We started having these youth programs every month.
I really liked the Mataji because she was great at everything. She used to sing, she used to play the instrument, she used to cook the prasadam, she used to give Bhakti Riksha lessons, and she could do everything.
He got very impressed. And he got involved in this Bhakti Riksha program regularly.
One of the other things that the youth always look forward to in the past few years has been the annual winter camp.
And then we had this winter camp, 3 days. We used to have this Mangalati and they used to give us training.
We have a 2 or a 3 day resort kind of activity where we go away from the city. And we have picnics, and it's not only fun and games, we also have some seminars or workshops. So it's a balanced mixture of fun and information.
On the last days, we give speeches or enact any pastimes.
I really liked the Kirtans, which was sung by Mataji, because her voice was very melodious and we really liked that.
We were advising our parents like we should stop this non-witch vibe because it is very bad killing all these animals, and then they were like, oh yeah, you're right.
We didn't have a car at that time, and they would take us to the temple, and this showed how much they actually cared about us. And even though we were not actually their family, they cared about us like we were theirs.
It was like a part of the family. Then even now I feel that I'm a part of this big family.
I studied my first loka, Tadvidi Pranipatena Pariprashnena Sevaya Ubadeshanti Tejnanam Jnaninastatva Darshinaha.
Which means?
Which means, actually I don't know. Translation.
He was very funny. He used to, you could talk to him about anything. He used to crack jokes.
After hearing all the lectures of Prabhu and Mataji, we stopped everything. Then we started our daily Bhakti Vriksha classes in our house.
She gave us a bead for the whole family. We would all sit together and chant round together as a family.
My name is Rangini Gopika Devadasi. I'm a chakra servant in Simantadweep Yatra. Istrigosri is a program we organize
when there are any conflicts or when there are any misunderstandings between leaders. Mr. Goshti is a kind of meeting where they can clarify all the doubts. And we were also given training how to behave in a Mr. Goshti, how leaders are supposed to talk to each other and the etiquettes that have to be followed by the members. But I feel that we need more training as we keep forgetting. People shouldn't be afraid of having a Mr. Goshti. Oh, another Mr. Goshti. I have to confront with many again. So we want more and more training how to resolve issues as our Guru Maharaj desires it.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
Right now we are having a Mahachakrapati meeting with all the top leaders of the Yatra. Then we also have different levels of leaders' meetings. So they meet regularly to discuss and review how they're progressing.
Out of 19, 8 candidate has been reviewed. So yet to review some other candidates. And then this is for the shelter as well as the initiation level.
They are fulfilling all the requirements that are expected out of such candidates. And it also helps in building up our relationship directly with them.
Among the sector leaders, you have to set up buddies.
Okay.
The lower level also, you must set up buddies in each margin.
Like, see, now we had this buddies meeting. Isn't it nectarian? Because you're concerned to help another person more than just the targets. It's the emotion which makes you, you know, gives you the pleasure to do it. Now, you know, okay, I will do it because, you know, I know my buddies book to acquire next week if I have not done.
See, you have vertical relationship. Horizontal relationship is very important. 40% of your time should be spent with peers. It is very easy to spend time with the people down your vertical. But horizontal, it is much more difficult.
We rarely get a chance to meet unofficially. Because there are so many activities happening within the Mahachakra itself.
Because they need to share about what are the problems they are facing within
Mahachakra.
Yeah, that kind of thing.
That's happening.
Okay, yeah, happening between you and whom?
All.
No, you give me one example with whom it's happening.
Yeah, we discussed with all our problems with Vajapran and Sukriti Prabhu, everything we had.
Whose house are you visiting often among your?
It's not necessarily house, but generally we have the Friday morning MC meeting is there. After the meeting, we discuss.
I'm not saying official.
After the general discussion is over, with Sukriti Prabhu, I want to discuss, I will have a discussion or Vajapran or anybody else.
Even though we have a very close heart-to-heart relation, but I don't think something is lacking.
That thing is missing, I know that.
Something is missing.
And because you are saying it is not missing, it is not happening.
There is two things, Prabhu. When there is a need, we talk. When there is no need also, we talk. Depending upon the time availability. That's
okay.
All.
You are saying it is not missing.
Nah. If he has something, if he does not have something, that's another issue.
It is not another issue, it is the same issue.
We openly heart and discuss. It's affecting our yatra or
personal life.
Something.
How many times have you called Mukutama Ravi Prabhu for programs or for personal meeting? How many
first
times?
Meeting? Hardly 4 or 5 times. All these 7-8 years, if you take. Still, like Rajapan Prabhu mentioned, we're all busy with programs only, organizing our own programs. So, sparing one day for our thing, it's not happening actually.
Correct. Like if I want to catch up with Sukriti Prabhu, it's impossible. Every day he has a program and he is completely engaged.
Well, then sometimes we can have a picnic together.
Yeah, that is what I was telling.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
So we love to have picnics. And we always look forward to having picnics here. We invite everybody from all the chakras and we have a picnic in a park. Sometimes we go out of the city and we plan beforehand who is going to bring prasadam. And we organize a lot of Krishna conscious activities, a lot of games for children, games for Matajis and Prabhujis, sometimes for families, and there are quizzes. The winning group is given a gift at the end of the program. And we also have mimes, like Prabhujis make a mime and Matajis have to identify what item the Prabhu is miming about. So these kind of activities, everything is related to Krishna consciousness.
So someone told me cricket.
Yeah, sometimes we do play cricket. Especially Indians love cricket. Children come with bats and balls, and adults are also tempted to play cricket. They all play cricket together. We also had once lady cricket, women. Mataji's also played cricket. And at least thrice a year, we have picnics in Semantadvi.
I understand that counseling is an important part of Bhakti Vriksha, isn't it?
Yes, of course. Because the Bhakti Vriksha leaders develop very close relationships with their members, they naturally ask them for guidance, even if it's like a relationship with their spouse.
To me, it was a shock when I first heard that there is a divorce between devotees, because I thought it's not possible.
They may not be professionally qualified to counsel, but the solution for every problem is a hunger for love, and this is what is the cause of deep-rooted mental illnesses.
Side by side with this sort of impression which some people may have that families are maya, you will find that the divorce rate goes up. When someone separates family life from spiritual life, after some time, what keeps families together doesn't exist, because you think that everything is transcendental, and then something breaks.
Psychologists, they may be better equipped to diagnose the problem, but will not be able to extend that kind of love for lack of time and also lack of means to do that. Whereas in the Bhakti Vriksha program, everyone gets unquestioned, unconditional love.
We make sure that family is the heart of the Bhakti Vriksha. That, for example, the leaders visit the homes of the person who's coming to the program. And then they make friends with the wife and with the children and the parents and the other relatives. And in this way, the family members get drawn into this. And the amazing thing is, if the husband and the wife are both involved in Bhakti Vriksha, then automatically the friction, which is now so prominent nowadays between husband and wife, reduces. Srila Prabhupada taught us, Bhaktivedanta Thakur talked about it, that if Krishna is at the center, then everything gets solved. Where the whole family is not involved in Krishna consciousness, generally in Kali Yuga, each of us has very strong self-interest, very, very strong. And so there is bound to be friction. But when both are practicing Krishna consciousness, all these frictions, it is not that it's not there. Personality differences are there. One may be doing one thing, another may be doing another, but both are working the same area of Bhakti Vriksha. And therefore, this commonality brings so much of joy that this joy is much bigger than the friction. So that the amount of counseling which we have to do for friction is much less.
We have also published a book called Counseling in Bhakti Vriksha, which addresses the basic techniques of listening to a person in a non-judgmental way, and how you empathize with them and make them work on this solution. Because the Bhakti Vriksha members are ready to accept Krishna consciousness as a solution to their problems.
Counseling in Bhakti Vriksha, we talk in detail about how devotees must counsel. But generally what happens is that small problems easily get solved in the normal Bhakti Vriksha. Then sometimes there are big problems where people have come to the point of divorce. That happens only when there is a lack of dedication. And then when it's easy for us to counsel them, and when they get back to dedication, they have come back and the whole situation has changed. So there has never been actually any divorce in spite of thousands of couples, when normally, even in Indian society, the number of divorces is much, much higher. But what happens is the husband and wife together are experiencing Krishna consciousness, the children are part of it. And always you find when the children are born in Krishna consciousness, they love so much. And the father and mother, they overcome everything because the joy of their children being happy in Krishna consciousness is part of their family life. No one, they don't view it as anything separate. And this is very important for the future life in ISKCON and society as a whole.
What is the real relationship? True love is when both remind each other to not forget the goal, to go towards Krishna. That is real love. You know, we can give a lecture easily or we can advise other people. But when we are faced with life situations, how do we react? Doing things which are correct, no matter what? Or do we resort to, telling lies?
ISKCON devotees will not feel superior to the others, and they will not denigrate all the good characters which others have got. They will not denigrate it. They will absorb all the good things which they can from the others, plus they add Krishna consciousness to it.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
My name is Mukunda Murari Das. I am the Yatra leader of Mathura Desh. One important aspect of Bhakti Viksha program is to invite regularly senior Vaishnavas and sannyasis. And they also conduct Vaishnava etiquette seminars, Grihastashram seminars. One batch of students have finished Bhakti Shastri courses recently, and around 50 students also took part in teacher's training course part one conducted by His Grace Atul Krishna Das Prabhu, who is the head teacher in Mayapur Institute.
The Mathura Desh devotees are really enthusiastic to study Srila Prabhupada's books systematically in courses like Bhakti Shastri, because they experience great empowerment in their own practice of Krishna consciousness and in their ability to share it with others.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
In all parts of the world, including the closed parts of the world, Bhakti Krishna is going on over there, because the nature of it is it's very quiet, it's done in a home and hardly anyone knows what's going on. So it is picking up. Even if there is a threat to democracy and there are all sorts of problems in the future which the world situation may bring, but Bhakti Vriksha is embedded in society. Maybe temples may not be allowed, but Bhakti Vriksha will flourish in those places because it doesn't depend on big expenditure of money. It's just something private going on at home and spreading through the way Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted it.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
And another format which is evolving is that many smaller temples in a city rather than one big temple. Because Bhakti Vriksha groups are spread all over the cities. And cities nowadays, as you know, it is difficult to travel from one part of the city to another with so many traffic jams. So probably in all the cities, you will have so many temples in different localities where people can travel within 5-10 minutes or 15 minutes. And smaller temples spread all over the city. I think this is what is the future.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
My name is Prasannatma Gopal Das. I'm the sector leader. Under me, 4-5 Bhakti Viksha is going on. Even my son also is conducting one Bhakti Viksha classes. And he's reporting me how is the preaching is going on.
Since the Krishna is present in our family, our thought process, our thinking level, it's similar. So this is the reason why we are united.
मुझे प्रसादम बनाना बहुत अच्छा लगता है और भक्तों की सेवा करने में मुझे बहुत खुशी होती है.
After marriage only, I came into Krishna consciousness because of my in-laws and my husband. And it is really nice for a mother to see her daughter singing Narasimha Arati and Hare Krishna Mahamantra.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
We are assembling early in the morning, 5 o'clock, once in a week, every Saturday. So 5 to 7, together we are chanting. It is 2 hours, 16 rounds. Like 30, 40, 50 people comes and do the chanting. Cell member, sector member, and the chakra leader. Legally, you're not supposed to create any sort of noise or a disturbance to your neighbor. Activity is restricted only to the namaz or a prayer in the mosque. People are observing rules and regulation very strictly here and leading very peaceful and blissful life.
Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
chaitanya. So I understand you are very active assisting your husband.
To husband ko assist karne ke alawa मैं अपना घर का पूरा केयर करती हूँ, अपना घर का जो डेटी है उनका केयर करती हूँ। इसके साथ ही मैं बाहर प्रीचिंग के लिए भी जाती हूँ, क्योंकि ये महाप्रभु का मिशन है। महाप्रभु बोले हैं डोर टू डोर जाके प्रीचिंग करो, एंड हियर आल्सो। बाकी समय मैं इधर जो हम जहाँ रहती हूँ वहाँ पर प्रचार करती हूँ, लोगों को भक्त बनाना, उनको केयर करना, उनको बच्चे को ध्यान कर, सब कुछ जो करते हैं उनको बुलाकर हम टुगेदर हम एक साथ मिलकर इधर प्रसाद बनाते हैं। और तो सब मिलकर सेवा करने से बहुत ही आनंद है, वो भी बहुत खुश है। और लेकिन एक बात है, उनको बहुत प्यार देना पड़ता है। इस मूवमेंट से हमने सीखा है, भक्ति विक्षा प्रोग्राम से हमने सीखा है कि उनको कैसे केयर करना है, कैसे लव एंड केयर उनको देना है। तो इसके वजह से हम जैसा बोलते हैं वो वैसा करते हैं। जो माता जी लोग को जो जैसा मैं बोलती हूँ कि आपको इधर आज आना है, आपको प्रसाद में हेल्प करना है, तो दे आर कमिंग एंड हेल्पिंग मी। तो उनका मदद से इतना बड़ा बड़ा भी प्रोग्राम, 300 पीपल, समटाइम 300 पीपल्स आर कमिंग इन माय हाउस। तो वी आर टुगेदर, वी आर मेकिंग प्रसादम एंड वी आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग, क्लीनिंग आल्सो, एवरीथिंग वी आर डूइंग टुगेदर। तो वी आर एंजॉयिंग इन दिस मूवमेंट।
जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य।
डू यू कुक एट एवरी सेशन लाइक दिस?
We help in cooking. We all cook. We help in every session. And we need 3 to 4 hours special prasadam so that they are attracted by prasadam and they come every week. Prasadam is more important than the preaching session. So for attraction, we need to make lot of time and make varieties of prasadam for attraction.
So you're
they are very much interested in prasadam, first of all. The people may tell every time we are coming through here because of prasadam only. So we concentrate more on prasadam.
Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda.
We had about 8,000 people to whom Prasadam, Lord Jagannath's Prasadam was distributed. The cooking started right from early morning, and huge containers of Khichdi Prasadam, sumptuous Khichdi Prasadam, very very nectarian Khichdi Prasadam was distributed to people who formed a big queue to get the mercy of the Lord. And they were very happy to have Jagannath Prasadam in this part of the world. This is really the Lord's mercy on all Indians who have left our country and have come here. I would like to share with you the unique way we celebrate Rath Yatra festival in this part of the world. We are not allowed to have an outdoor ratha here due to restrictions and regulations that are there in this country. Way back in 2004, His Holiness Jayapadaka Maharaj came up with this idea, how about doing an indoor Rath Yatra, just like how they conduct sports indoors when it is not possible to play outside. And then we worked on this idea and we got immediate success in having an indoor Rath Yatra. And then over the last 10 years we have seen that this Rath Yatra festival has become the biggest event in this country of people from the Indian origin.
This year we are having a fantastic celebration. It was really impressive to see the crowd much more organized in their pulling of the cart, and separate trips of cart pulling for ladies and the men. I was really impressed to see our countrymen so well behaved and following the discipline.
Hare Rama, 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 Hare Rama,
this year we saw 8,000 people participating in pulling the Ratha cart of Lord Jagannath.
Even more attractive, we organize many cultural programs like dance, drama, and high energy kirtans by even youth and everyone participating with joy. Everyone got a chance to express their artistic talents. This is the day everyone poured out their love for the pleasure of the Lord.
You would be amazed to know that this event of the Rath Yatra was organized just in a span of 2 to 3 weeks. And how did we do this? The entire community came together to put up this wonderful event, and all the artistic talents within our community contributed to make this event a grand success. Right from the carpenters who could make this huge Ratha cart, which is about 14 feet in height. And this dance performances were choreographed by youth who are getting trained in the classical dances. The drama was directed within 2 to 3 weeks. The fundraising happened within 3 weeks. So the whole event came to shape in just a question of 3 weeks. This, I believe, is the strength of the Vaishnava community based on the Bhakti Vriksha principle.
It took a full hour to give a full answer to what brought Jagannath to these deserts. We even heard why.
To re-establish the principles of religion, it says, I myself appear millennium after millennium. That's what.
In closing, we're back to pulling the Rath cart shown at the opening of this film. This one is in the open air, but strictly on the premises of a Bhakti Vriksha temple inside the laborers' camp.
Oh,